にちは、皆さん。お元気ですか？ Hello, how are you? Today, I'm going to explain you the grammar using this particle, mo. Like this, in my channel, I teach you Japanese gradually, little by little, with the grammars, vocabularies, and sometimes expressions. And also, I explain Japanese culture, like bonsai,Karate, martial arts, and anime, and the different dates. So actually, I upload 6 videos each week. 3 of them in the English version, and 3 of them in Spanish version. So I hope you, if you want to learn Japanese with me, not only Japanese language, but also Japanese culture, I hopeYou subscribe my channel and you follow me. That would be very, very nice. Well, the first today, I'm going to explain you this mo. Do you remember this nani? This means what? Dare? Who? Doko? Doko? Or dokoe? Dokoe? Dokoni? Like that. Doko? This is where.And with these question words, with mo, that is going to be the different. Nani mo, nothing. Dare mo, no one. Doko mo, or dokoe mo, doko ni mo. I will explain you later. That is nowhere. But we must use in the last of the sentence is the negative form. In Japanese, we say hitei.Hiteikei. This hitei, it means negative. So when we use this negative form, for example, nani mo nai. Nani mo arimasen. There's nothing. Well, this mo can use in many ways. But today we're going to learn with negative form. But in the future, we learn with this nani mo, dare mo. With this,Here can be affirmative too, but this is going to be the different meaning. And so, mo has got some many meanings, the different ways of using. At first, we are going to remember we already studied this mo. A mo, this. In here, mo, this is to or also like that. For example,Do you remember this word, 鉛筆, with this kanji? 鉛筆. 鉛筆, this is pencil. 鉛筆. 鉛筆. So I'm going to tell you one example. これは鉛筆です。ね、これは鉛筆ですよね。これは鉛筆です。でも、これも鉛筆です。見て、ね、これも鉛筆です。Like that. The next example using mo in the meaning of also. Do you remember this word? 昨日、今日、明日。昨日、yesterday, 今日、today, 明日、tomorrow. Maybe you see.Kanji many times here in my channel. So maybe even if you can't write these kanjis, just watching this, maybe you recognize it. So that would be very nice too. Well, so do you remember this word? And these words for the supermarket, like 牛乳 milk, 卵 egg, pan, bread.野菜、vegetable, 肉、meat, 魚、fish, and this verb, 食べます、to eat, 食べます、食べました、the past tense, I ate. So I'm gonna tell you this phrase. 昨日、魚を食べました。昨日、魚を食べました。アイスクリームも 食べました。アイスクリームも食べました。私もそう、昨日魚を食べました。 I ate fish yesterday and I ate ice cream too。 私はアイスクリームも食べました。 And also I can say 私も、 me too。 So now we are going to begin with this new way of grammar、 何も and a negative form。 For example、 何もnegative、 何も、 that's gonna be nothing。 For example, do you remember this word 今朝、 今朝、 this morning、 this け、 this 漢字、 now、 今、朝、 so the morning、 now、 今朝、 this is this morning、 今朝。 And again we 食べます。 So if I say 今朝何も何も食べませんでした。今朝何も食べませんでした。I didn't eat anything this morning. And with this, 飲みます。飲みませんを飲みませんでした。何も飲みませんでした。I didn't drink anything. 飲みませんでした。買います。To buy. 買いません。Don't buy.買いませんでした。Didn't buy. So, 昨日何も買いませんでした。昨日何も買いませんでした。I didn't buy anything yesterday. With します。This verb is to do something. します。しません。I don't do. 昨日何もしませんでした。昨日何もしませんでした。I didn't do anything yesterday.So let's practice the second one with 誰, with who, who, 誰? 誰も, no one, with a negative, no one. For example, do you remember this verb? 来ます, to come, 来ます, 来ません, don't come, doesn't come, 来ませんでした, didn't come. So, 昨日, 誰も来ませんでした。昨日誰も来ませんでした。昨日誰も来ませんでした。Yesterday nobody came. Like this. And this one, this verb, I must, it's a little bit difficult because I must, this means to meet someone. To meet someone. But this verb needs to have this ni after the person. For example, if I say,昨日先生に会いました。昨日先生に会いました。Yesterday I met a teacher. 先生に会いました。Yesterday I met a teacher. And if I want to say, yesterday I didn't meet anyone or I met no one. How can I say that? If I say, 誰、昨日誰も会いませんでした。This is not correct. 誰も会いませんでした。With this verb, it's not correct. Because we need に with a person. 誰? It's the person who. So, the right answer will be 昨日誰にも昨日誰に Then I add も昨日誰にも会いませんでした。昨日誰にも会いませんでした。I didn't meet anyone yesterday. Because this I must, this verb is special. We need に. But if I say nobody goes, 誰も行きません。誰も行きません。Nobody goes. In this case, just like 来ます, we don't need に like that.But with I must, yes, you have to remember, 誰にも会いませんでした。Okay? Well, now with this word, どこ? Where? So, どこも? That would be nowhere. For example, with this verb, 行きます。行きます。To go. 明日、 どこも行きません。明日、どこも行きません。I'm not going anywhere tomorrow. 明日、どこも行きません。But I can also say, 明日、どこへも、because this A with a direction. Do you remember? 明日、どこへも行きません。Or you can say, 明日、どこにも行きません。I'm not going anywhere tomorrow. どこへも、どこにも。That is correct.、Hmm? どこへも、どこにも。But you can also omit just どこも。どこも行きません。Like that. For example, 今日、私の猫はどこにもいません。今日、私の猫はどこにもいません。Today, my cat is nowhere. Till now, we learned with 何、誰、どこ、but we didn't learn いつ、いつ、it is、when, but いつも、いつも、this is different, very different. いつも、it means always. いつも is always, so it's different. So we must be very careful. Do you remember this word? 朝、晩、朝、morning, 晩、evening. So, and this verb, 起きます。This one, 起きます。To get up, 起きます。And 何時 with the time, we must say に。And if I say, 私はいつも朝7時に起きます。私はいつも朝7時に起きます。I get up at 7 o'clock. I always get up at 7 o'clock in the morning. 私はいつも、いつも always. 私はいつも7時に起きます。Like that. And another example. 散歩します。散歩します。します。To do, right? 散歩 This is a, like a walk. So 散歩します。Go for a walk. Go for a walk. 私の妹はいつも朝と晩犬と散歩します。私の妹はいつも朝と晩犬と散歩します。犬 dog. So 私の妹 my little sister, my younger sister, always go to the walk, go for a walk with her dog every morning and evening. 私の妹はいつも朝と晩いつも朝と晩 always in the morning and in the afternoon. 私の妹はいつも朝と晩犬と散歩します。でも私の猫はいつもうちにいます。私の猫、my cat. 私の猫はいつも my cat is always at home. うちを家 is the same. The house or home, うち家。私の猫はいつもうちにいます。So this いつも means always. And if I say いつもどうもありがとう。いつもどうもありがとう。That means thank you always. Thank you as always. いつもどうもありがとうございます。Like this. Now we are going to do a quiz with 10 questions. And the first 5 is going to be a dictation. Okay, soPrepare your paper and pencil. And if you are an advanced student, maybe you can write using kanji too, not only hiragana and katakana. But if you can't write kanji, okay, but hiragana and katakana. Number one, 一番目。昨日デパートへ行きましたが、何も買いませんでした。昨日デパートへ行きましたが、何も買いませんでした。昨日デパートへ デパートへ行きましたが、行きましたが、で、てん、てん、it's like a comma。何も、何も、何も、買いませんでした。買いませんでした。OK? 昨日デパート行きましたが、何も買いませんでした。Number two, second, second.パーティーで誰とも話しませんでした。パーティーで誰とも話しませんでした。パーティーで、パーティーで誰とも、誰とも話しませんでした。話しませんでした。パーティーで誰とも話しませんでした。パーティーで誰とも話しませんでした。OK? 3番目、3番目、3rd。お父さんはいつも6時半に家に帰ります。お父さんはいつも6時半に家に帰ります。お父さんはお父さんはいつもいつも6時半に6時半にうちにうちに帰ります帰ります。お父さんはいつも6時半にうちに帰ります。お父さんはいつも6時半に家に帰ります。4番目、the fourth。週末、どこへも行きませんでした。週末、どこへも行きませんでした。週末、週末、the weekend, the weekend。どこへも、どこへも、行きませんでした。行きませんでした。週末どこへも行きませんでした。週末どこへも行きませんでした。5番目、Number five, the fifth。いつも何時に寝ますか？いつも何時に寝ますか？いつも、いつも、何時に、何時に寝ますか？寝ますか？寝ますか？いつも何時に寝ますか？ Well, this the fifth one is the question, right? いつも何時に寝ますか？ This is the question. So, please answer this question too. After your dictation, please answer.Answer this one. Just from the 6 to 10, you are going to translate these phrases that I'm going to tell you into Japanese, just as you were a translator, okay? Number 6, 6番目. I'm not going anywhere next Friday. I'm not going anywhere next Friday.Okay? 7番目 7th. I go with you too. I go with you too. Just like me too. I go with you. I'm going with you. Like, I'm going with you too. Me too. Me too. I'm going with you. Like that. Okay? That was 7. Now 8. 8.8番目 I don't understand anything. I don't understand anything. I understand nothing. 9番目 Nobody read this book. Nobody read this book. Nobody read this book. That was 9. So, 10番目。The last one, the 10th. You didn't drink anything in the party. You didn't drink anything in the party. You didn't drink anything in the party. You drank nothing in the party. Okay, that was all the questions. Do you think this video was useful for you? And did you like it? If so, please, 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 please don't forget to give me a like. And if you share my videos with your friends, that will be a great help for me. And even if you didn't subscribe my channel yet, please subscribe my channel, because in that way you can continue learning Japanese with me. 今日もここまで見てくださってどうもありがとうございます。じゃあチャンネル登録といいねボタン、そしてお友達とこのビデオシェアしていただけたらとってもとても嬉しいです。また会いましょうね。じゃあまたね、バイバイ。